song that has a certain feel-good factor. When you hear it in the car, you crank it up. It became one of the biggest pop songs of the 80s. Have a listen. Fronting that band was Katrina from Katrina and the Waves, and she is here at Studio 10 this morning. Let's welcome her. Woo! Katrina Leskovich, welcome.
Thank you.
Studio 10.
Thank you.
I mean, we all love the song.
Yes.
We adore it.
Let's hear you sing it then. Come on, bright and early. I'm walking on sunshine. Whoa. I'm walking on sunshine. Whoa. I'm walking on sunshine. Whoa. And don't it feel good?
I feel good.
Brilliant and lively song, but
yes.
Do you get sick of it?
No, no, I don't get sick of it. It gets easier and easier, and I enjoy singing it more and more. I mean, as you just demonstrated, when I start singing it, people join in, so it becomes very, very easy for me.
It makes
don't
people
have to
so
do much.
Happy.
Well, that's nice. Mm. That's it makes me happy, too. I mean, I always say I'd rather represent a really happy song than have be known for a really dreary one when you have to sing it so many times.
And it's also one of those very few songs that's actually timeless. Like, it's not a typical 80s song. It's actually just got this incredibly good feel, the chords, the melody,
yes. Well, thank you.
Everything just works really well. How did it come into your hands? Because you didn't technically write it yourself, did you?
Our guitar player in The Waves, Kimberly Rue, wrote the song, and he had really bad bronchitis. It was a very cold February in England. He rode his bike 27 miles to our rehearsal studio, and he said, I've got this new song. It's called, it's called Walking on Sunshine. And it's like, oh, well, that should brighten things up. It was kind of not a very characteristic song for us because we were a little bit more Ramonesy, a bit more rock and roll. And that was very, very lightweight. But after we rehearsed it once, I did say, you know, Kim, that Sunshine song, I can't get it out of my head. And he said, well, like that's a good thing if it has a little bit of the irritation factor.
Yes, that's right.
What do you mean, yes, that's right?
No, I was going
to not irritating. It's such a, as we're saying, feel-good bit, and I love the hey bit.
Right.
Did you add that?
I added that all by myself. But I don't have a swimming pool to show for my hey, so hey!
That definitely makes it. But of course, you do know your way around writing infectious pop songs. You won Eurovision.
Yes.
Back in 97. I think we've got a, I think we've actually got a clip. Here we go.
Look at that lapel. Oh, my God.
Good back, though.
Ask me about that shirt. Seriously, ask me about that shirt.
Really?
Yeah.
How about
no, I'm
that
just
shirt?
Saying you've got to ask me about
something about that shirt.
Thank you. I bought that shirt at the Cambridge Market in England for £3. Oh, wow. I mean, look at that lapel. It's ridiculous. And I wore it. My mother is Irish, and when I won the Eurovision Song Contest, it was in Ireland. So I thought, this green shirt will be great. But I wore it to all the rehearsals. And I mean, this thing was like walking to the closet at night by itself. I didn't have anything to wear at Eurovision. They always come at you with like these Union Jack dresses or really inappropriate stuff. And finally, somebody said, wear that green shirt you've been wearing all week. It might be really lucky. That thing was rank by the time I went in. Thank you, Ben.
So you hadn't watched it?
I hadn't watched it. No, no. Oh, wow.
That must be the only Eurovision outfit that cost less than $10,000.
Yes, for sure.
That's extraordinary.
It's lucky. Australia did really well this year.
Yeah, didn't we?
Wow, that song should have totally won.
Thank you.
Oh, my God, I had such goosebumps.
Yeah.
Rob, John O'Coleman, my neighbour.
Yes.
I can vouch. I used to go past Katrina's house and I'd see that green shirt on the line.
I was going through, as I was going through the bins looking for food scraps. But actually, you saw that Dammy, the Australian entrant. Yeah, she won.
Robbed.
And then they suddenly went, oh, yes, but now we have to count some more votes. It's a little bit like an Australian election, isn't it?
It was a brilliant song. I absolutely loved her whole performance. Well done.
Yeah, she was amazing. Now, you're on tour with some other big acts from the 80s that have made their mark, but what can we expect from you on stage? The green shirt and a few other things?
Well, no, the green shirt was actually given to, sold for some Belgian Eurovision museum, which never actually existed. No, I was completely hoodwinked into
Bring
that one.
The green shirt.
Can I just ask, how much did it sell for? Because if it only cost you $3, that's a tidy profit.
I gave it away. But then last year I saw it on eBay. You know.
No.
Yeah. Yeah. Shrunk a little bit. Or did I just grow? I don't know. Oh, it's going to be a great tour. Yeah, which I'm really happy to be here. A little bit jet-lagged, but I guess you're tired. People always say, oh, I'm so jet-lagged. Well, sleep.
I can't wait to come along because I love all of that
Well,
music.
We've got Martika and Berlin and Lamal and Susie Q. And it's going to be a lot of fun. They only give us...
A lot of nostalgia sharing.
Indeed, there's a lot of nostalgia. People are really happy. Sometimes they come dressed as funny things. I don't know why they always come to our shows dressed as like Scooby-Doo or something. You know, why? Or the relaxed T-shirts. I mean, it'll be great. They're only giving me about 7.5 minutes to quickly sing Walking on Sunshine in another song nobody's ever heard of.
Not Walking on Sunshine and then an encore of
Walking on Sunshine, But it'll be great. It'll be great.
Oh, Luskin, you are just as gorgeous and as pleasant as the song that you sing.
We're all walking on sunshine. Totally 80s, the Totally 80s tour, and you can get all the details and tickets at metropolistouring.com. Thanks again.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.